In this video, I'm going to be showing you 7 visual and amazing card changes that you can do using Sleight of Hand. And since these are visual and also done by using Sleight of Hand, you might need a little bit of practice in order to do all of this. So sit tight and enjoy the video. Let's start with the most simple snap change. It's literally like snapping your fingers. So basically for this trick, you're at first going to do a double lift and then hold these two cards in the formation like you're about to snap your fingers. So basically you're holding the two cards with the thumb and the middle finger, and the index finger just stays on the top of the top card. Now from this point, you're going to pull the middle finger backwards right under the thumb and push the thumb a little bit forward so that it gets in contact with the index finger. And when you do that with two cards on your hand, the front card comes behind the back card, and that way it also stays hidden. Now if you do this movement fast, it looks like that the card just changed in the blink of an eye. Now after the change, bring the deck of cards close to this hand so that you can drop the back card on top of it and then drop this top card just like that. And you also have to practice this because you have to do all of these things simultaneously in real time. This is an original color change of mine which I call the wheel change. So basically I'm going to take a card and put it in the center of the deck, and when I'm going to spin it like a wheel, it is going to change. And this is very easy to do. For this, all you have to do is just a simple double lift and hold these two cards in this formation. And then you're going to use your thumb in order to create a separation in between these two cards. Now with the other hand, you're going to use your thumb in order to riffle down almost half of the deck. And at that point, when you're going to insert these two cards over here, you're going to make sure that there are at least one or two cards in between the gap that you created with the thumb. Now once you're in this position halfway in from length and breadth, you're actually going to leave the cards just like that. And the bottom card is going to rest on the corner of your thumb right over here. And because of that, the bottom card is going to have a pivot point just on the top of the thumb. So that way when you start to move the two cards together, the top card slides away and the bottom card actually spins. And when you do this under the cover of your hand, it looks like that you just spin that same card which just changed right in front of their eyes. And once you're in this position, use your thumb in order to push that card inside up till certain point from where the spectator cannot see it. And that's how you're going to do the change, and it's going to be complete. You can take out the card just like that. This one is a sequel to the wheel change, and it is also an original trick of mine. So basically after doing the wheel change, if I want, I can change this card back into the card which it was before the wheel change. So basically this trick is very easy to do since the wheel change actually sets up the location of the cards exactly favorable for this trick. So once you do the wheel change, the top card, it comes face up and it stays right here, sticking a little bit outside. And then what you're going to do is basically you're going to take the changed card and put it right under the face up card which was the card before the change, and then push it all the way inside and match these two corners together and pinch it right over there so that it becomes a pivot point. Now at this point, you're going to place your middle finger right at this edge so that whenever you pull these two cards together, the card that is coming out, it actually strikes your middle finger and it gets squared with the bottom card. And that way when you pull these two cards fast sideways, it looks like that the card has again changed into a different one. And after that, you can just take these two cards as one and then just turn it back onto the top of the deck. This next one is called the Bertram change, and it is one of my favorite changes because it gives you a whole lot of possibilities for your ideas to implement within the changes and make it more unique. So here is how you're gonna do it. You're going to take two cards and put it as one just like that, and you can twirl it as many times as you want. And then while spinning the cards, all you have to do is basically use these four fingers in order to strip the card while turning it flat to the ground surface. And once you strip the card, you're actually going to hide that card inside your palm in the Tenkai palming position, and you're going to do that at a certain angle from where the spectators won't see it. Then after that, you're going to match these two corners and pinch them together so that whenever you move your hand downwards, the card actually slides just like that. So basically when you're pushing your hand down the card, you're actually pushing the card with your thumb, and the other fingers on the other side are actually going to square the top card with the bottom card, and that way it will look like a visual change. And if you're using two different colored cards of different colored backs, then the card change will look like that the card has totally changed. And in real time, you're going to put all of these moves together so that it looks smooth and fluent. This one is called the duck change, and it requires a lot of practice because it requires perfection. So for this change, you're going to take the top card and turn it over, and while doing that, you're going to take a break under the next card, and then you're going to drop the top card face up. Then that way you're going to have two cards above the break, one face up and one face down. Now from above the break, you're going to hold the card from the corners using your thumb and the middle finger, and also on the same side. Now from here, you're going to push these two cards together forward and then use your index finger in order to bend the cards upwards. Then keep the other index finger on top of it so that it does not bend anymore. And you're going to apply pressure with your thumb and the middle finger continuously. And then suddenly let the middle finger slide off the edge. And that way both the cards are going to shoot out and they are going to twist in the mid-air and they are going to fall onto the top of the deck just like that. And since this is going to happen with a considerable amount of force, this change is going to happen very fast and it will look visual. And keep these fingers right over here so that whenever the card twists in the mid-air and falls onto the top of the deck, they immediately get squared without separating. And that way it will look perfect and visual. And since there's a considerable chance of having an accident with this trick, you have to practice this trick a lot so that you can do it smoothly and effectively. This is a visual variation of the earnest change and it is also very angle sensitive. For this trick, at first you're going to do a double lift and then with your other hand you're going to wave over the card backwards, and in that cover you're going to do two things. You're going to push the top card forward with this thumb, and from this exposed portion you're going to pull the bottom card backwards just like that with the other thumb. And then as soon as the cards separate, you push this card over this card while pushing the top card backward, and that way you're going to square the bottom card on top of the top card and it will make it look like that the card has changed. And since this hand is acting as a half cover, it is way more visual than the actual earnest change. This one is called the Cardini change or the blink change, and this is one of the easy ones among all the others that I've showed you in this video. Now for this one, you have to do a double lift at first, and then you're going to hold the deck of cards in this position with all the fingers on one side and the thumb on the other side. Now you have to move your middle and the ring finger away for the change, and you're going to use your pinky in order to slide down the top card to the side of the deck just like that. This happens suddenly, so you're not going to apply gradual force, you're actually going to apply a sudden force, while with your other hand you're going to cover the top and flick with the fingers. Now both of these movements happen at the same time and this hand stays on the top so as to make it as a cover. So as soon as the change happens, these are the position of the card and your hands that you end up with. Now from this point you're going to grab the entire deck with this hand and you're going to lift it up. And then you're going to slide down the moved card to the bottom of the deck and twist the deck at the same time so as to use it as a cover. So in real time, this is what it happens and this is how you clean up. And that's how you're going to be doing this trick from the correct viewing angle. So this was a mashup of few of my favorite visual card changes and I hope you enjoyed this video. So thanks for watching. And if you're new here, then make sure you subscribe because that's what helps me make amazing videos like this one for you guys. And one more time, thanks for watching. Peace.